Hey, and welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we're going to talk more about the new program I'm offering called Cake in Real Life. It's basically a program where I teach you how to live your dream cake life where you want to be. In other words, do you want to be a baker? Do you want to be a decorator? Do you want to be both? Do you want to do cupcakes only? Maybe you just want to do baked goods. Maybe you want to do decorative cookies, or maybe you want to do crazy, insane sculpted cakes. That is totally your choice, and I'm here to help you achieve whatever that goal may be. You can do so much with each of those. You can do a ton with decorative cupcakes, like the unicorns you see here, to wedding cupcakes, to bridal showers, first birthdays. The sky is the limit. Same thing with decorative cookies. You can do shortbread, you can do sugar cookies, you can do wedding favors, you can do birthday parties. Again, the sky's the limit. And the holidays, oh my goodness, you could do so many cookies on the holidays and even back to school like you see here. So I'm here to help you. I'm here to give you recipes. I'm here to teach you how to make icing. I'm here to teach you how to make decadent cakes with chocolate dipped strawberries and cookies and cream and carrot cake and red velvet cake and all the yumminess you can imagine. So maybe you just want to make really yummy cakes. Maybe you don't care about all the crazy decorations and sculpted. That's great too. I can help you do that. Maybe you want to make really simple buttercream cakes. You don't want to get into the fondant. You don't want to get into any kind of figures or making things out of modeling chocolate. That's all good. You can do wedding cakes. You can do anniversary cakes, first birthday cakes, graduation cakes. You don't have to venture into the fancy carved fondant work if you don't want to. There's so much that can be done with a great buttercream icing. And a lot of these you're seeing now are just buttercream. So I can teach you the different types of buttercream, the one I like to use, all the different cake trends right now, like this one. Oh, it's so decadent. So you really can do whatever your heart desires. You can do simple wedding cakes like this, where there's no icing. You can also just really rake in the orders around the holidays, whether it's be Easter, Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas. You could just pump out a ton of stuff on the holidays only and only be like a holiday baker, a holiday decorator. You only make a ton of stuff around the holidays to make a little bit extra income, and that's it. Now, you can definitely get into more of the custom work, where you, even if you have a buttercream cake, you add the fondant decorations, you pop on the gold, you pop on the unicorn, fishing theme, elephants, baby showers, Star Wars, whatever it may be, you still can choose, do you want fondant or buttercream, but you're really getting into more of the custom work. The customers in this way of thinking are definitely going to have a very specific design in mind. They're going to give you a theme. They're going to be sending you pictures they found on Pinterest, or, you know, this sort of thing. So that's really more of a custom design. It's super fun. There's a huge market for it out there. I do a lot of this type of work, a lot. So all of these cakes are cakes that I've made. And as you can see, I've done several different themes over the last several years. I've been in business for about 16 years. So I feel like I've done every theme under the sun. I work with a lot of buttercream. And I do add fondant decorations to most of my cakes unless they ask for me not to. All of my wedding cakes are buttercream unless, again, they ask me to make it fondant, which is rare. And I really enjoy the big custom cakes. I will say it, a lot of things that you need to think about are how many orders do you want to take on per week. So, for instance, if you're doing simple cakes with buttercream only, you can do a lot more than you can sculpted cakes with a lot of fondant work. So that's something you need to take into account. Also, you need to think about, are you considering this as a side hustle? Or are you thinking more of a small business? Are you going to work from home? Do you want a brick and mortar, like an actual storefront? These are all things to consider, but I can help you brainstorm. I can help you break down the pros and cons and decide what works best for your lifestyle. The unicorn cakes, oh my goodness, what a trend. You could literally have made an entire business just based off unicorn treats a couple of years ago because we did so many of those. Wedding cakes, you can do only wedding cakes. You don't have to do all the other stuff. There are a lot of vendors out there that just specialize in weddings. There's also a lot of cake decorators that just specialize in custom work, like this T-Rex face. They only do the fancy stuff. So you can really decide what your specialty is, what you want to be known for. Do you want to be known for insane lace work and beautiful gum paste flowers? Do you want to be known for your fondant figures that you put on every single cake? Do you want to be known for your immaculate piping details and how much detail you can add to a cake with just buttercream? Really, what do you want to be known for? Do you enjoy the baking side of it more, or do you enjoy the decorating side of it more? Those can really play a part in what type of business would work best for you. Even if you're working full-time, this is something you can do on the side. You can be a hobby baker who only takes a couple of orders a month just to keep your skill level where you want it to be. Or you could be a full-on full-time baker as I am, where I'm taking around 15 orders per week. It really is a totally different ballgame, and it really depends on what you want for your life and what you want for your schedule. All of these cakes I can teach you to make. We can start with the very basics and go up from there. We can talk about marketing, using social media to your advantage, getting out there into your local market. Really, the sky is the limit when you really think about what you want for your cake life. I started out as a home baker. My kids were small, and I just wanted to bake a few cakes for my house. And of course, that builds into your baking cakes for your family, for your friends, for your neighbors. And you grow from there. Then I worked part-time for someone else as their decorator and their baker. Then I decided I wanted to do it on my own, and I just moved up from there. Now I do a little bit of everything. I do a lot of buttercream. I do a little bit of fondant. I do decorative cookies. I do pumpkin rolls and Christmas cookies around the holidays. I really like to do a little bit of everything. But I will say, I've learned a lot over the years about what not to do, about how many orders are too many, about taking on too much and regretting it later, no matter what the income is that you bring home at the end of the week. So join me on this journey. Let's meet, let's talk, let's plan out your next steps. Let's really make your cake life what it should be. We can start at the beginning and work our way up until you get to the point where you feel confident and are selling cakes every week, have orders every day, and have repeated customers, because that is the key to success, is the customers come back time and again because your cakes taste good and look good. That is the key. So join me for my Cake in Real Life program. Let's build your dream cake life. Let's talk. Find me on social media. You can find me on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest. You can email me, and all of my details are at the end of this video.